Well, welcome back everybody from break. So today we're doing Nintendo GameCube. Last time was about Dreamcast, but now we're doing Nintendo GameCube. So we all know the GameCube, right? A lot of people loved it, but it did sell less than the OG Xbox and the PS2, but it managed to outsell the Dreamcast by with 22 million units, which was just 2 million units lower than the Xbox sold. So the GameCube did have an impressive library of games, like Super Mario Sunshine, Luigi's Mansion, Mario Kart Double Dash, Donkey Kong Jungle Bee. So you guys know the controller, right? The controller was said to be so good that they're still making it for the Nintendo Switch today. So the GameCube switched to just having two handles, unlike its predecessor, the 64, which had three handles for some reason. And it now has two joysticks with analog clicking, just like its predecessor did, but it only had one joystick, so that doesn't matter. But the GameCube did have its troubles competing with the OG Xbox and the PS2, but it's still made out to be a good home console. Enjoyed this episode, just stay tuned for the next episode. And next episode, I will discuss Xbox. Yes, the OG Xbox from 2001. Yeah. Stay tuned for the next episode, and I'll see you later.
Good morning, Bridgehampton School. Mr. Barker here, back for WBEE Virtual Radio. We are finally back with another episode of Lucian's Console History 101. I have been waiting all week for this new episode to air. On today's episode, Professor Midori is dropping knowledge on the GameCube. I hope Weather Bear's editing skills are to your level, Professor Midori. Hey, today is Thursday, April 28th. It is a B-Day. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
That was Maya Verzosa from the first grade with our pledge today. Great job. Let's check in with the Weather Ducks. Wow, that is a cute baby duck, but I don't speak duckling, so I'm just going to say that it is in the 50s today. So hey, here are announcements for the day. Secondary students, a final reminder that the last day to audition for the spring play is today. The performances are June 3rd and 4th. Contact Miss Sanchez with any questions. And Miss Ozu and the Elementary Student Council hosted a successful comedy show. Here are some pictures of the event and some never-before-seen behind-the-scenes footage. It should be airing on Netflix by June of 2058, so stay tuned. 2059. And Summer Camp at the Hive is back. You have about one more week to sign up. Here are some details about this exciting opportunity. It is for students entering K to 6th grade. It starts on July 5th and goes to the 28th. It's from 8:30 to 2 p.m. Monday through Thursday, and students will take part in lots of activities such as drama, gardening, cooking, and more. Registration closes on May 6th. That is a week from tomorrow. Go register now. And we have a yearbook reminder. The deadline to add in a dedication has been extended to tomorrow. It is $15 a dedication, and you can purchase through balfour.com. That is www.balfour.com. And the Robotics Club is selling merchandise to raise money for their upcoming events. You can purchase them in the main office with a check or cash. Contact Luna Picard with any questions. And lastly, we are continuing with our last week of National Autism Awareness Month. Let's check in with our fact of the day.
People with autism have feelings just like you and me.
They may express differently. Stay tuned for the t-shirt contest, please.
So true. Remember that we all have feelings, and we need to think about the words we use to others. Let's continue to build each other up. And no meowing for Mr. Lib. I am surprised. And hey, as always, send us what you're up to. We'd love to have you on the announcements. All right, that's it for our announcements for the day. We do not have any birthdays, but we will announce our last April birthdays tomorrow. So from WBEE Virtual Radio, this is Mr. Barker signing off. Until tomorrow, have a great day, Bridgehampton family. And remember, positivity is a choice, and wear black and gold for Spirit Day.
As always, please remember to learn well
and to stay safe so you graduate and participate in something you love as when you leave Bridgehampton.
Make sure you wash your hands with soap and put your mask on, and please stay safe.